Christ is born.
Glorify.
Let's try it again. Christ is born.
Glorify.
Christos genate. Today we're celebrating, in the new calendar, we're celebrating St. John the Baptist, the synapses, or the gathering of St. John. In the old calendar, we're celebrating Christmas. So Merry Christmas to those of you that are celebrating that great feast today. I wanted to read a homily about St. John the Baptist, and it's basically based on Matthew 6:10, and it's on the submission of the will to God. Blessed be John the Baptist, for he fulfilled the gospel before the arrival of the gospel. Going into the wilderness, St. John the Baptist gave himself completely to the will of God, both his body and his soul. The will of God was carried out in his body on earth, as well as in the heaven of his soul. Neither hunger nor wild beast did any harm to his body throughout the many years that he spent in the wilderness. His soul was harmed neither by despair and loneliness, nor by pride in heavenly visions. He sought neither bread nor knowledge from man. God granted him everything that was necessary for him, because he gave himself up completely to the will of God. This is really a great lesson to us. We don't need, we should never place our hopes on man. We should never place our hopes on men. We should only place our hope in God. But if you are to place your hope in God, then that means you need to give yourself to God. Our whole relationship as Christians, our relationship is a one of synergy, of together, between you and the Holy Spirit. It's not one, we don't sit around and wait for the Holy Spirit to strike us. We open our souls and we prepare to work with the Holy Spirit and allow the Holy Spirit to work through us. So as Christians, St. John the Baptist is a beautiful example of that very thing. He was called to go to the wilderness. He didn't know how he was going to survive. He didn't know what he was going to do. He lived a hard life, but he lived a God-inspired life. And of course, because of him, all of history became different. He led the way to the Lord. He presented the path. He made smooth the path to God. You and I, we're not reading just some book that's about dead old people. We're reading a book that's instructing us how to live. And you can live. I can live. We can live as the apostles and the disciples. But that's not by just some warm feeling. And you should have a warm feeling, but you should be uniting your mind and your heart into Christ. When you do that, things change in you and without or around you. Our relationship with God was demonstrated by St. John the Baptist. He didn't look for a beautiful life. He looked for a beautiful life by serving God. And so you and I have the option to run after and be one with God. It's going to be a little different for each one of us. We don't all have to just eat berries and locusts and honey. We can live a life that you're called to live, but you have to live, you have to get on your knees to know what you're called to do. And then when you know that, you submit to God in the direction you go. This is not always easy, but when you let go of the things of the world, when you let go, then all of a sudden you can be filled with the Holy Spirit. You can know what God calls you to do, and those things are mighty. They might seem not important, but you have something to do today. That is, you need when you go home to pray to God. Am I following that which you want me to do? Lead me. Tell me what you want me to do. And then with your whole heart, struggle to do that. Sometimes it doesn't make a lot of sense. But if you do that, you're going to see beautiful, beautiful fruit. Just as St. John, in other words, St. John led the way for Jesus Christ himself, who then ultimately sent us the Comforter, the Holy Spirit, who resides in us now as Christians. So if I have any gift for you on Old Calendar Christmas, I want you to have that same desire that St. John the Baptist did. It doesn't matter what anybody else thinks. It just ask God, what am I supposed to be doing with my time, my treasure, my resources, my body, my mind? What am I supposed to be doing? And if you really submit, he's going to answer you. Maybe in a strong feeling, but he's going to answer you. And so I pray that you'll do that today, that you'll really talk with each other at home, that you'll pray about what is it that we are supposed to be doing this 2018. Because if you do that and then you submit to him, mighty great things will happen, not just in this parish, but in this city, in this country, in this world. You and I may feel sometimes small, but in Christ Jesus, anything is possible. Could you please rise? And please help me call down the Holy Spirit. Heavenly King, comfort.